better lately. I am a radio professional. I've got my big guy. If you ever get a chance, get on the YouTubes. Go search out Rush Limbaugh and Tom Likas. Listen to that audio. Yeah, the Rush Limbaugh that the world got made a ton of money. But I'll tell you, the Rush Limbaugh that's on that tape with Tom Likas, if we would have gotten that Rush Limbaugh, he'd have been bigger than anybody on this planet Earth, as far as entertainment goes. But that's neither here nor there. It is Y'all Big Broadcast, the Sunday radio show, Jiggy Jaguar Experience. Thanks for tuning in to the Big Broadcast. We have live video on our website at JiggyJaguar.com when it works. We are live from the KJAG Radio Studios in the great Salt City of Hutchinson, Kansas. 2 Central, 3 Eastern, 12 Pacific, 1 p.m. Mountain Standard each and every Sunday. From 990 WBOB out there in Rhode Island. Also the mix on Tuesdays. And of course you can find us on iHeartRadio and podcasts. Because I can say that on this program. Podcasts are available. A talk show. Now from time to time, as you all know, I like to go mess around with the good folks in the radio industry. I like to go see how the other half lives, as they say. Well, we found a good one fairly recently. Holy shit. I recently applied for a gig out with Town Square Media. Now, of course, Town Square Media is a corporate radio group. They are corporate as corporate gets. They are fantastically corporate. I sent an email off for a job posting for something called a Central Minnesota brand manager for country music. Now, what in the world did I just say? That is the key. What in the world did I just say? That gobbledygook, that word salad. What in the world did I just say? Well, let's talk about it. I'm trying to pull up the original ad. It was to a gentleman by the name of Paul Shea, who forwarded me on to a headhunter, talent recruitment, more word salad. More word salad. So I gave them my cover letter. So they were very interested in talking to me. They had Paul went ahead and forwarded my information on to a woman by the name of Savannah Boulard, who, of course, as you can tell, when you first pull up her email signature, her pronouns are she and her. So, of course, we know she's a good little corporate gal. She is a corporate recruiter and content for Town Square Media. Not Polestar Town. Town Square Media, completely two different corporate groups. So she gets in touch with me, and I basically blow her completely off. Not on purpose, but I blow her completely off because I honestly don't think that she is going to want me to work for them. So she sends me an email at 8:40 a.m. 6 days ago on a Monday that says, I hope you're doing well and appreciate you taking the time to read my message. Paul Shea sent me your way. I'm a recruiter for Town Square Media and would love to chat with you about our opening at WWJO. Would you be interested in hopping on a quick phone call with me to discuss this opportunity further? If so, please let me know some days and some times that work for you, and I'll get something on the calendar. Or for your convenience, check out my availability and throw me a time on my calendar here. Because, of course, all the calendar invites, because we're doing corporate radio. That's what they do. They have calendar invites. So, I send her a calendar invite. And she gets back with me, and she's all excited. Oh my God, she's excited. So, I go over and I look at this WWJO. This WWJO, which is a country station out in the middle of nowhere, Minnesota. St. Cloud, Minnesota, wherever the hell that is. Now, here is how they have a Facebook page. Now, first of all, we need to go back and look at part of the reason Town Square Media, they have job openings. Now, let's look at this job opening, because I'm assuming that it is still open. Because I got news for you. They're not going to fill it. Especially after they're making comments that they make. So, their original ad. Let's see if I can pop this up here so people can read this. This is quite interesting. Quite entertaining, as I would say. Yeah, very entertaining. So, let's look at this. Job openings for Town Square Media. Let's look at this. Digital and radio content leader. Radio host, WWJO. Now, first of all, what in the world is a digital and radio content leader? What in the world does that mean? Now, to me, that means program director. So, they clearly tell you in the ad, in bold, that this is a full-time in-office position, which means that they are not going to pay you to do this remotely. You've got to literally move to St. Cloud, Minnesota. So, they put in their ad that Town Square Media has an opportunity for a digital and radio content leader and host for WWJO. They're looking for a strong content creator and someone to be a champion on the streets. You must be a 360-degree talent to propel the brand to new heights. Now, what in the world does that gobbledygook mean? What they want is they want someone who's going to do radio, but they also want someone who's going to do video and posting on social media. And they want someone who is going to go out and promote the brand in a remote situation. And they want people to go out on the streets. And they want you to shake hands and kiss babies and do all that. Now, here is where I got in trouble. And here is where Town Square is a digital-first company built in tandem with great radio brands that emphasize great local content and community involvement. You must be excited to embrace and prioritize the digital world alongside the terrestrial and be ready to learn and grow with the world-class team. I've got to go out with him and his team. Okay, so let's look at their website here. More or less, let's look over here. They have YouTube. They have Facebook. They have Twitter. They have Instagram. I do not see a TikTok presence. Now, they have a story on their featured section on their website about getting rid of TikTok, but they don't have an actual TikTok presence. Let me tell you something. I do social media for the Red Shed Music Venue here in Hutchinson, Kansas. I've put things on their TikTok that get more views on TikTok than all of the other social medias combined. No wonder Twitter, Facebook, and others want to ban TikTok. So they're a digital-first company, but they don't have a Twitter. And this is another thing. Let's go back and look at this. Twitter. Let's go look at this. Let's look at their Twitter presence, their Facebook presence, their YouTube presence, Instagram presence. I always love to do this. First of all, their Twitter presence. Let's go look at their Twitter presence. As you can see clearly, September 20th, 2022 was the last tweet. We are in March 19th as of this taping, 2023. They have not used their Twitter in over a year, almost a year. They have 156 following. They have 3,557 followers. But they haven't used this thing since September. But remember, kids, they are a digital-first company. So let's go back to Instagram. They have an Instagram presence. They are following almost as many people as they have following them. That is never a good sign. On top of this, if you go through their posts, they have photos. They don't have videos. They don't have any videos. When was their last post on social media? According to this post, 6 weeks ago, January 31st of this year, it is now March. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Town Square Media is a digital-first company built in tandem with great radio brands. Let's go back and look at their YouTube presence. Their top video is from, by the way, the last video they put was 7 months ago. They are a digital first company. Now, you would think that this post here, this is pretty amazing. They've got a guy in studio doing a live, what you would think would be a live video. It's not a live video. It is a still picture with the audio from the radio station. It's not even a real video on a place called YouTube, which is a, last I checked, video platform. Once again, they are a digital first company. Applicants must be social media savvy. Regularly contribute great local content to the station's website, mobile app, and all social platforms. All social platforms. Once again, they haven't touched their Twitter since last September. But they are, ladies and gentlemen, say it with me now, a digital first company. Digital is not an afterthought at Town Square Media. It is part of our DNA. So let's go look at their Facebook page, because they're real proud of their Facebook page. They're really proud of their Facebook page. So let's go look at their Facebook page. Let's go look at posts. They have a post that they did 24 minutes ago that has absolutely no likes, shares, or comments. They have one they did 55 minutes ago that has no likes, shares, or comments. They have another post they did an hour ago. Same story. So let's do this. Let's go down and look at some of their other posts. From, let's say, I don't know. Now, as you can see, most of these are news posts. Most of these are news posts. So the news department obviously contributes to their Facebook. Here's the deal. They are a country station. I don't think anyone's going to care about what the news department is up to. Because as most people know, you get your news from social media. You get your news from notifications from apps. You don't get them from websites. So here's an engagement. Three people like a story about Yellowstone. Three people like the post. Now, quick question that I have is that if three people like the post, why do they have 32,000 people, including two of my friends, who like the page? 32,000 people follow the page. Six people have checked in. But yet, they only have, as you can see, three people who like a post from a very popular television show that was uploaded or posted a day ago. Most of their posts have one or two likes, six likes on a Kenny Chesney album, seven on something about a church, nine about somebody being arrested for doing something dumb. They have something about a Minnesota state trooper that's got a little bit of engagement. But as you can see, overall, most of the stuff they're posting on their social media, nobody really likes, cares, or gives a crap about. Now, they do have this, which is shocking to me, that a Minnesota dancer amazed the audience with a solo performance, and it got 98 views. But that was 2 days ago. But they have, hold on, 32,000 people who follow the page. Remember, they are a digital first company. Now, part of the responsibilities is you have to write assigned Facebook posts along with other social media platforms, including Twitter and our mobile app. So I would like everybody who's working at that company to be fired tomorrow, because what is the excuse for this? They haven't touched their Twitter since September, but yet they have a Facebook page, which apparently has posts on it from 2 days ago. I could do this all day long with this post. I could do this all day long. But I will not do this all day long. I will just simply say, I then had an interesting interaction with Savannah where I sent her a critique. She, of course, responded in her typical millennial odd way, and wow, was this not fun. I think I hit a nerve, kids. Because as you can see, she posted this. I'll get this adjusted because I'm a digital first company. She went ahead and let me have it. Holy smokes. I appreciate the feedback, but I'm afraid that's not the case. Town Square takes digital content creation very seriously. So seriously, we haven't touched our Twitter account since September of last year. Although that's not what she says. and we work diligently to tailor our social media presence to fit the needs and desires of each of our market's listeners. So I'm still wondering why there's no live videos on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. The Facebook page for WWJO, for example, has nearly 40,000 followers and gets regular engagement. Yes, regular engagement. Let's go back over here and look at the regular engagement. The regular engagement, such as 7 views or 7 likes, 8 likes, 11 likes, 57 likes, 16 likes, no likes, 3, 1, none, 1, 2, 1, 4, 7, 1. And then there's countless stories on their site of absolutely no engagement at all. We nearly have 40,000 followers. Well, if you have 40,000 followers, why do you only have 7 likes on some of your posts? Shouldn't you have more? And the web traffic we get from the page alone makes up for 40% of our referral sources. Well, first of all, I didn't ask any of that. And then at Town Square, digital means many things, whether it's posting an engaging local article on the website, sending a push notification through our mobile app. So she's giving me a bunch of gobbledygook. She's getting ready to give me gobbledygook here. Scheduling newsletters, going to events. Now, I love this part where she says going live at an event. Going live at an event. They haven't touched their Twitter since September 20th. They haven't put anything new on their YouTube page in 7 months. They haven't went live at all on Instagram. There's no posts of live videos. There's no live videos. There's no reels. There's no nothing. These are all graphics. That's all these are. Their graphics and their posts. So I don't know where they're going live at. What was the last live video on their award-winning prized Facebook page that has 40,000 followers, but yet no one has bothered to engage on any of these things? They go live. They go live on a regular basis. They go live from events. They go live, by the way. By the way, last time they went live, 2 years ago. 2 years ago. So they regularly go live at events. 2 years ago. So then she says something about how, well, we lead with intent and thoughtfulness for what it's going to serve our audiences. We appreciate your feedback, but I certainly understand that Town Square isn't a fit for everyone. For this particular opening, we are looking for a 360-degree content creator and brand manager, which is a program director. So, she basically got mad because I attacked her. And her lack of the fact that they haven't touched their Twitter in, as you can see here, almost a year, maybe not even a year, 2022. Their Facebook, they haven't went live on Facebook they went live 2 years ago. They haven't touched their YouTube channel in 7 months. And they've never gone live on Instagram, but they're a digital-first company. And according to her lovely email here, they have advanced digital solutions that are able to offer small to enterprise clients through digital divisions, such as going live on Facebook 2 years ago. Either way, it doesn't matter. So then I think, okay, what does her LinkedIn look like? Let's go look at her LinkedIn. Well, let's see. She started out as a she started out, this is what's really funny about this whole thing, is that she started out as a server at hostess, then a server, then she became a graphic design individual, she wrote freelance, then she was a digital creator, and then she went from doing all that to becoming a shift supervisor, then back to being a digital creator, and then she got the lucky job of a lifetime working at Town Square Media. We're going to go through, fast forward through all that. She was a program director of a station somewhere. And then she became a corporate recruiter. So, either way, yeah, we'll follow Town Square. So here's the deal. I don't want to be in a corporate radio environment. I want to work somewhere, like, for instance, their Twitter presence. Let me give them some free advice on the Twitter. If you're updating your Facebook page, you can update your Twitter at the exact same time. If you're updating your YouTube, you can also send that exact same video to Instagram. If you're sending the video, they make these programs now. They make these applications now. Hero Post, Hootsuite, TweetDeck, all of these places that allow you to send things to other places. So that was my experience with radio. I also went and looked at their website. On their website, they have a list of events. They have events that they do. 98.1 events for the radio station, and then they have concerts, and then they have a community calendar. Like, for instance, they have a concert coming up, Ashley McBride, Matt Still, and Jay Johnson, and more, Saturday, June 17th and 18th, the Moon Dance Country Weekend. Well, if the station is promoting this on their website, I sure hope that there's going to be interviews on their website in audio and video from all of the artists. Because if not, I wouldn't be promoting that on my website. But remember, they're a digital-first company. So that wraps it up here from this segment. When we come back, oh boy, we've got more coming up on the other side. It is your world famous Jaguar radio broadcast. I just say.